Salam everyone, hello and welcome, this is Aya. In today's video, I'm going to talk about Milo Art Markers as an alternative for Copic. I have searched for alcohol-based marker and I came across a lot of brands. However, I try, you know, to filter my search by searching for a brush nib, not, you know, a chisel nib or these tiny nibs, I don't know what you call them. I mean for better blending. So I came across exactly for 6 brands, and yes, I bought them all because I really would like to answer so many questions about, is there any alternative for Copic? Copic are really expensive. Is there any brand can substitute Copic? So that's why I did the search. So this video is not sponsored, no one sent me anything. So all the series that will come for Copic alternative, it's all my opinions, and I bought everything by my money. So let's talk about Milo. So Milo Art Markers, it's a very simple, looks like Copic, but in Copic you will see that there is more information written, you know, on the pen itself, on the marker itself, but in Milo nothing, only the brand and with the way to chisel nib and the other one for the brush nib, and the same has this gray ring that shows, that gray ring indicates, you know, the direction for brush nib. As you see, they are really the same. The only thing that really bothered me, that there is no, I mean, the color or the number name is not written on the marker itself. So I have to pick up, you know, the marker and see the color. So, and this is really bothering me because, I don't know, when you color, you want, you know, to check quickly the number of the color. Now I'm going to try all the colors now in front of you. I have stamped these cute images by Waffle of Flower. Links will be in the description box for the names and everything. So I swatch all the 48 markers. This is the set I found. I'm not sure if there is less set or there's a larger set. I'm not sure, but this is what I found on Amazon. Here is, you know, the marker swatch. As you see, this is a little bit windfall because, of course, that the cover or, you know, the package, the color and the package itself is different than the real one you sketch, but this one's really far. I mean, the CLO, when you swatch it, is orange. So it's not all the colors, of course, but some of them. So that's why really you have to swatch all the colors and write the numbers. This is number one. Number two, really, you have to try them out because there is a gap between the numbers, because this is a smaller set. Again, I'm not sure if there is smaller or bigger sets, but this is 48, so there is a gap between numbers. And I'm not sure how numbers work. That's why I have to try to, you know, choose 3 colors near to each other and try to blend them outside, you know, in a piece of paper to see if I can color with them or not. So here is the yellow shades, 3 shades of yellow, and for that I choose smaller images. Of course, you're going to draw like a large piece of whatever you want to draw with. I'm not sure if this is the best marker or not because I do not draw for that, and this is one. Number two, because I'm not sure how these color blend together, so I choose smaller images to color with. So anyway, usually when you choose any smaller image, it's really easy, you know, to blend the colors together. So here just I got bummed when I see that the ink smear to my alcohol marker. I don't know why all of them, they were, I stand to use Gina K McGlowing ink, but the girl was fine, but the flower is not. But this has led me to another good point, that anyway, the brush nib got, you know, this black ink, but I tried to get rid of it by, you know, smushing the color on the paper, and I was afraid that really this would come and contaminate and, you know, ruin my brush nib, but no, it just disappeared after, you know, I just smushed the color on my paper. Anyway, I'm going to stamp them again on a piece of paper, right? This time I use Memento ink. So now we have the shades of pinks. Again, there is a gap between the colors, and I'm going to show you that the colors are a little bit far away. So there is a solution, of course, that you have to keep working and blending and choosing the lightest color, you know, to blend everything together. So now you will see me trying the pinks, and I want you now to see that the pinks are a little bit far from each other. You see, here is the pink. I really love this color. I mean, each color alone is fantastic, but together, I don't know. No. I need to turn like a purple. However, so that's why you have to swatch them, blend them, write the colors, and see what's the nearer to each other. However, if there is a larger set, I think this would be a bonus and this would be really a good Copic alternative. How far I like it? I like it so much, really. You will see now the images, how it would gonna turn out. Really fantastic. Unless the things that, I told you about the things that I don't like. So as you see, the difference 12, 2, 6, 3. Again, the numbering system, I don't know, because even there is no paper or brochure, I mean, explain their brand or how the number system is working, nothing. You have to explore everything by yourself. So bear in mind that this is my first trial. If you want more reviews about it, just let me write for me in the comment and I will keep exploring and blending. Maybe I can do ready chart for you and you guys download it. So let me know. What else? Yeah, so the trick here, I'm trying to see the nearest colors to together and blend them together. If there is a far, I would just try to, use the lightest color and blend everything together. Or do a blending chart, on a piece of paper, and you just keep experimenting. Maybe 6 got with 20 is fine, maybe 20 with 30 is fine. Yeah, so you have just to explore. So I'm gonna really fast forward because I'm going to fast forward now, as you see. So overall, I like this marker, and I feel that this is a very good alternative for Copic. Maybe the downside that one of the downsides that there is no, there is no refill for it. To be honest, I don't refill my Copic, and if any Copic is finished or got ruined or whatever, I just buy a new one. So if this is, of course, it will not be in a, I mean, for a long run, this is a waste of money because you're keeping throwing your color. But however, this is depends for how far you really use your colors. But this is with the Copic is fine. The next step, really, I want to try mixing both of them, like using Milo with Copic markers. And if you're interested to see something like this, please write down for me in the comments. So here we came to the end of the video. I hope you like it. And if you want to see what I'm going to do with these cute characters, hit the bell to be notified for next video, because I'm going to turn all these characters into cards. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye.